Hi everyone, welcome to Online Study for You, one step solution for all your placement needs. In this video, we are going to do the analysis of today's subject in QT exam. So make sure to watch the complete video. We have talked to many students and according to this, we have collected some important questions that are going to be really, really helpful for all of you, those who are having exam in upcoming days. So make sure to watch the complete video. Do subscribe this channel. I'm sure that this channel will help you a lot in your preparation journey. So do subscribe the channel. And just a quick update, do check our online study for you app. On this app, we are uploading various useful resources for all of our students so that you can prepare, you can learn, and you can grow. So do check our app. Link for the app is given in the description itself, right? Just a quick update, guys. We are launching our TCS NQT coding crash course, that is a live course, which is going to start from 20th of Feb, right? Recordings of the classes will be available to all of you so that you can revise the concepts. It is a wonderful opportunity because you must be knowing that TCS is again hiring 19 and 20 batch students and the exam is on 10th March. Right, so this is a wonderful opportunity to be a part of this course and clear all your concepts to be a part of such a renowned company that is TCS. The link for the course is given in the description itself, right? So after doing the proper analysis, we collected some questions, right? There were 10 technical MCQ questions basically in the subject in QT exam, right? Mostly the questions were output based questions. One or two of them were error based questions. That is, a code is given to you and you have to find out the error, that which line is having error. Suppose some like they have changed something in the code, they have changed some, it can be a logical error, a syntactical error, a syntax based error, anything. So you have to determine that which line is having the error, right? Other was output based question, that suppose a code is given to you and according to the flow of code, you have to determine that what will be the output of the program. So this was the questions. And some questions were like, a question was that name the queue in which you can do the insertion and deletion from both the ends, right? So I hope that you all must be knowing the answer. And if you know, comment it down, right? So this was one question. One question was based on binary search, that they have given an array and they are following the strategy that we use in binary search. I hope that you know how do we solve the binary search, right? So they were following the same strategy. And then they ask that which algorithm is that? Simply they have given sort of algorithm and they are asking you the name of this algorithm. So the answer for this was binary search, right? So make sure that you are clear about these sort of algorithms, that is searching algorithms, linear and binary search. Very, very important algorithms they are. So make sure to be clear about them. Sorting algorithm. See, if you cannot cover all the algorithm, like we have team sort, bucket sort and all. So the most important one I'm telling that you must be aware of, that is selection sort, bubble sort, insertion sort, merge sort, and heap sort. Very rarely they will ask, but be aware of it. And quick sort, that is also important one. Maybe a case that they can ask you complexity and all, right? So these are few sorting algorithms that you must be knowing. It is very, very important for you. Right, so make sure to cover the concepts regarding these sorting algorithms, searching as well. And one question was based on stack, that a stack was given and some elements were given. So they were doing some sort of push and pop operations, right? So in data structure, we will consider the technical MCQ part. So from stack, from queue, they will ask you operation based question. That is, they are pushing some element, they are popping some element. Right. So how many push operations it took? How many pop operations it took? So make sure that you are aware of it. And from stack, they also ask questions regarding infix to postfix conversion. Mostly ask question this one is. So make sure that you know how to convert infix to postfix, postfix to prefix. We have videos on these sort of questions. Make sure to check those videos. Make sure to watch those videos before sitting there in the exam. It is very, very important, guys. And this is just, I'm telling for you only, right? So make sure to check those videos. And for tree, I have told it many times, traversals are very, very important. They have asked the questions based on traversal around 100 times. Yes. So make sure to check the questions on traversal. It is very, very important. and they can ask you about the height of the tree. Suppose they have given you some notes, so they can ask you about the height of the tree. So these sort of questions you can expect. And the questions that were there, I already told you that were from error based output queue and this stack one question, right? So questions were easy to moderate. According to what student communicated, questions were easy to moderate. So they were not that difficult, right? And now come to the coding part. So coding this time is kind of easy when compared to the October exam, right? I'm not saying that for all the slots, for everyone that is the same, but to the students that we communicated, according to them, coding was kind of moderate to difficult. Not that easy, obviously. So one of the questions were the series-based question that TCS usually asks, and mostly they ask questions based on series. So one question was series-based question, and another question was that you have to determine the Armstrong number within a given series. So some series they have given, and according to in this series, in the given range, you have to determine how many numbers are Armstrong number. Right, so we have the code regarding Armstrong number on our YouTube channel. Make sure to check that video. Make sure to be clear about these small program like Armstrong, prime numbers, strong numbers, palindrome. These are very common program. LCM and GCD as well. So these are very common programs. Be clear about them. Series based programs they usually ask based on AP and GP. So make sure to check this as well. And that's it. Yeah, there's nothing difficult. Just try from your side, try your best. And obviously you will get placed in your dream company, in one of the renowned IT company, that is TCS. So thank you so much, guys. I hope this analysis, this video has helped you. So make sure to like this video. Make sure to subscribe our channel. Bye-bye.